I want to tell you about Jim Grant, a UNICEF leader in the UN, a visionary, and a most practical man for getting things done. Jim was born in China and lived in China for his first 17 years with many Chinese friends, speaking Mandarin, very much in the culture. When he was 17, he came back to the United States. He went to university. He knew he wanted to work internationally. Jim, in 1980, was appointed executive director of UNICEF, the United Nations Children's Fund. UNICEF was involved with education, with health, especially education for girls, children in especially difficult circumstances, children in war, children in crisis situations. Jim added a new focus to UNICEF because at that time, 15 million children were dying every year of readily preventable causes. And Jim said, we should focus on actions that would reduce child mortality. And there were four: encouragement of breastfeeding for better nutrition, immunization to prevent children getting polio or measles or other killing diseases, oral rehydration, that was to deal with diarrhea. You may think diarrhea is just an annoyance when it happens. It was killing 5 million children a year. And the other thing was monitoring children, bringing children to clinics and getting them weighed. Jim had another idea. Let us have goals, not just encouragement of those things, but 80% of children in each country and on average in the world should be immunized. And so from the 1982 to 1990, this gave a focus, goals to measure how UNICEF was doing. By 1990, 80% of children in developing countries had been immunized. Child deaths had fallen by 3 million a year, from 15 to 12 million. And Jim then had another idea. We should celebrate, but we should set new goals for the 1990s. And so Jim did something which the UN had never done before: have a summit meeting with heads of state, prime ministers. We even had one king to the meeting. That had never happened before. And people expected, well, if you're going to have a summit meeting, you must discuss trade or economic or political issues. No, Jim said, we should focus on the most important, children. And by then, the UN itself had discovered that goals were important. And so in 2000, the UN set, under Kofi Annan's leadership, the Millennium Development Goals, and in 2015, the Sustainable Development Goals. Jim Grant died in 1995. Today it's 2020. I wonder if Jim was alive today, what he'd be saying we needed to do. Well, first he'd be saying we need an international perspective, and too many countries tackling COVID are just looking at themselves, not looking at the wider picture. Secondly, Jim would be saying, we need to think internationally with a strong United Nations, stronger than today, with the support of countries all around the world. Mostly the developing countries do support the UN. It's the richer countries who think they can do without it. And third and finally, we need leadership. Jim Grant showed leadership. You don't wait for someone to tell you what to do. You look at the situation, you see what you can offer, and you offer it and lead. And that actually is a lesson which every one of us can learn and adopt. You can be a leader. You can have a vision for the future, working with others, finding teammates with whom you can work to achieve a better situation. He was a fantastic leader. He was a visionary, but in a very practical way.